What's up, YouTube? Alvaro here. Welcome to the Bilingual Stock Market channel again. You guys already know this channel. This is the YouTube channel in which we talk about the markets, but we do things a bit differently because we talk about the markets in English and Spanish as well, so you can pick your preferred language. And in this video, and as I do it Mondays through Thursdays, I want to make a quick stock market update. I want to break down some technicals, going over the S&P 500 and the Nasdaq 100, which are the most important indices of the United States stock market. And at the end of the video, I am going to break down from a technical standpoint as well the three stocks that are going to be on the top of my watch list for tomorrow's trading session. So let's get started, and we'll still have 15 more minutes in today's trading session, and the markets are having a phenomenal day, guys. The four major indices of the United States stock market, Dow Jones, Russell 2000, Nasdaq 100, and the S&P 500 are trading as of now in positive territory. We have had a very solid rally throughout today's trading session, and most importantly, guys, a lot of severely beaten down stocks such as Tesla and other mentioned technologies, Beyond Meat and Apple, just to mention some of those, have seen today a very nice recovery. And before going over the S&P 500 and the Nasdaq 100, I wanted to show you some interesting information about earnings reports that are coming out this week. So on Wednesday, after close, we're going to have Nvidia reporting earnings. And by the way, guys, I am going to link down below a video that we posted yesterday about Nvidia. In that video, I broke down Nvidia from a financial standpoint and also from a technical standpoint, and I also explained in detail what the stock split that Nvidia wants to carry out is about. So we have Nvidia on Wednesday after close. Then on Thursday, this is going to be an interesting day for some retail stocks, guys. So on Thursday, before open, we're going to have Best Buy, Dollar General, Dollar Tree, and Burlington, and also TD Ameritrade, right? All right, that is going to be before open. Then on Thursday, that very same day, but after close, after hours, we're going to have Salesforce, CRM, reporting earnings, and Casco. Gap, as well, is going to report on Thursday after close, and Ulta Beauty, so watch out for these earnings reports throughout this week. And by the way, guys, keep in mind that on Friday at 8:30 a.m. Eastern Standard Time, we will have very sensitive and important economic data coming out. On Friday, and as I said before, at 8:30 a.m. Eastern Standard Time, the core inflation rate is going to be booed out. Remember that the core inflation rate measures the price range of goods and services minus food and energy. So that is going to be a market mover, all right? And you have to pay close attention to that information that is going to be put out at 8:30 a.m. Eastern Standard Time on Friday. And now I want to show you some trades that I closed throughout today's trading session. And the first one is going to be Ethereum. And in the case of Ethereum, guys, you know that we had such a crazy weekend when it comes to cryptocurrencies. So I pretty much spent all my weekend buying Ethereum. So I gotta move my screen over here. So I made six purchases, guys. Take a look. On May 21st, I made 6 purchases, all right? So I ended up investing $6,446 at different prices. Obviously, I was buying Ethereum at $2,500, then I purchased more Ethereum at $2,400, then at $2,100. And the largest purchase that I made throughout the weekend was at $1,900. I was actually sleeping, guys. This was from Saturday overnight until Sunday. So I placed a buy order for Ethereum at $1,900, and I got filled overnight. This was a almost $3,500 purchase. So I ended up pretty much investing $6,446, and I sold this Ethereum position, let's put it that way, today at $7,045. So I ended up making a, there goes the market. Okay, so I ended up making out of this swing trade something like $600, and I actually opened a new swing position on Ethereum, as you guys can see over here. So this morning I purchased more Ethereum at almost $2,300. So let's go ahead and take a look at how that Ethereum position is looking like as of now. And as of now, I have an unrealized gain of $161 on Ethereum. And today I also closed a swing trade with DraftKings. And in the case of DraftKings, I opened this position on May 12th, purchasing 50 shares at $43.71. Then on May 17th, I purchased 25 more shares at $43.21. Then the next day on May 18th, I purchased 30 more shares at $44.82. And on May 20th, I purchased 20 more shares at $44.16. So I ended up building up a 125 share swing position, and I sold those 125 shares today at $47.43, making $435 out of this swing trade. And if you remember, both DraftKings and Ethereum were a stock and a cryptocurrency as well that were broken down here on the channel, and I told you pretty much exactly the way I described the way that I was thinking about taking these swing trades. And now let's go ahead and take a look at the S&P 500, guys. So we ended up going up today 0.99%, almost 1% up in today's trading session. So I am going to zoom in here on the 4-hour chart and take a look at the RSI, guys. The RSI is at 62 points. I saw some people getting excited today about buying put options, SPY put options, right? And that is pretty much gambling, guys. Take a look at this. We have seen before the S&P 500 trading with the RSI, with the relative strength index, up to 84 points before seeing a pullback. So buying put options here, or SPY puts, is pretty much taking a gamble, guys. And remember, the trend is your friend until the very end. So today the bulls failed at 42.10, pretty much, and this index closed at 41.97. So from a resistance standpoint, guys, the most important level that I am going to be watching tomorrow is going to be 42.17, which is a level in which the bulls failed at back on May 29th. And if that level of resistance happens to be broken to the upside, we could see tomorrow, this is pretty much in the cards, a new all-time high on the S&P 500. All-time high for the S&P 500 as of now is at 42.38. So I think that we are very, but very likely to see a new all-time high in the S&P 500 tomorrow or throughout this week. From a support standpoint, guys, I am going to be looking at tomorrow at 41.80. 41.80 is a previous area of support and resistance for the bulls in the S&P 500 that already acted as a support in 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5 opportunities before, but it also acted as a resistance back on April 16th. So to the downside, 41.80. And to the upside, watch out tomorrow for the bulls taking on 41.17, or maybe, this is definitely in the cards, bursting above all-time high at 42.38. And when it comes to the Nasdaq 100, this index went up today 1.72%, and it closed today's trading session at 13,641 points. So I am going to zoom in here on the 4-hour, and we have pretty much the same scenario that I just described in the case of the S&P 500. The RSI, or the relative strength index of the Nasdaq 100, is at 63 points, rather. I have to get glasses, guys, definitely. Sorry about that. So the RSI of the Nasdaq 100 is at 63 points, and we have already seen the Nasdaq 100, the good old Nasdaq 100, trading with the RSI at almost 85 points before seeing a pullback. So we could still see the Nasdaq 100 going up tomorrow, despite the fact that the RSI is at 63 points. So what's going to be the most important homework for the bulls in tomorrow's trading session, and that is going to be 13,700 points, no doubt about it, guys. That is going to be a very tough spot for the bulls in the Nasdaq 100, because we are talking about a previous area of support and resistance, a very important area of support and resistance for this index. As a support, 13,700 points already acted in 1, 2, 3, and 4 opportunities before, but it also acted as a resistance back on February 9th and also back on February 19th. So 13,700 points, to the upside. And from a support standpoint, guys, tomorrow I am going to be looking at that 13,500 points, which was the low of today's trading session. And if we happen to see a big drop in the Nasdaq 100, which looks very unlikely, because this index is looking, as of now, very bullish. So watch out for 13,300 points, which coincides with the 180 SMA and the 4-hour chart, and is a previous area of resistance that already acted as such for the bulls in the Nasdaq 100 in 1, 2, and 3 opportunities before. So let's see how everything plays out tomorrow for both the S&P 500 and the Nasdaq 100. And the first stock of this video is going to be good old Virgin Galactic, ticker symbol SPCE. And in the case of Virgin Galactic, this stock went today on an absolute tear after the company announced a successful test flight that took place on last Saturday. So Virgin Galactic went up today, guys, almost 30%, God almighty. It went up today 27.62%, and it closed today's trading session at $26.89. So what am I thinking about Virgin Galactic here, guys? This is a tough one. Take a look at the RSI. The RSI of Virgin Galactic is, as of now, at 75 points. So I'm thinking, I am going to zoom in here at the 4-hour, that this RSI should take a rest sooner rather than later. So if Virgin Galactic, and by the way, guys, let me show you, because as of now, I have a swing position already opened on Virgin Galactic. So I own 100 shares at an average price of $27.75. And as of now, I have an unrealized loss, courtesy of Mr. Richard Branson, of $100. So I'm thinking, and this is my plan when it comes to this swing position, if Virgin Galactic happens to take some rest in order to the RSI to come back down to earth, I think that this stock could pull back down to $23-ish. $23-ish, as I said before, is a previous support that already is a previous area of support that already acted as such in 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5 opportunities before. So if I happen to see Virgin Galactic visiting or paying a visit to the $23-ish, so I am going to probably purchase, I would say, 50 or 100 more shares of this stock. And take a look at these, guys. The 180 SMA on the 4-hour chart would back up this area of support for the bulls if Virgin Galactic happens to visit $23. Or who knows, because this is a very volatile stock, guys, if Virgin Galactic happens to fill the gap up to the next important area of resistance for this stock at around $33.50 or $34, I am going to be locking in the profit. $33.50 or $34 is a previous and a very important previous area of resistance for Virgin Galactic that already acted as such in 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5 opportunities before. So from a technical standpoint, we can expect the bulls to have a very hard time dealing with $33.50 or $34. If any of you wants to play a momentum trade on Virgin Galactic, let's say that you purchase shares of this stock at $27, maybe tomorrow at market open, and if you sell those shares at the area of resistance that I just told you guys about, near $34, then you are going to be locking in a profit of almost 15%. But what about purchasing shares of Virgin Galactic over the 180 SMA on the 4-hour chart at $23? In that case, I'm selling a group of shares purchased at that price at $33.50, that would imply a profit of 32%. So what is going to happen with Virgin Galactic, guys? This is going to be an interesting one. As I said before, this is a very volatile stock, so I wouldn't rule out Virgin Galactic to fill the gap up to $34, even with the RSI being at 75 points. So let's see what happens tomorrow with Virgin Galactic. And now let's go ahead and take a look at good old NEO. NEO went up today 5.37% and it closed today's trading session at $35.89. And let me show you guys, and I think that I already showed you this swing trade that I am taking on NEO. So as of now, I own 335 shares at an average cost of $35.78, and I have over here a tiny unrealized gain of $71. So what's my plan when it comes to this swing position? And take a look at this, guys. Take a look at how the 180 SMA and the 4-hour chart is acting as a critical area of resistance for the bulls of NEO at around $37.15 or $37.30. So I'm thinking, guys, that if tomorrow NEO can burst above this 180 SMA on the 4-hour chart and good volume and momentum, it could potentially fill the gap up to the next important area of resistance for the bulls of NEO at around $43. $43 is an area that already acted as a support for the bulls of NEO in 1, 2, 3, and 4 opportunities before, but it also acted as a resistance back on April 1st and also back on April 26th. So from a technical standpoint, we can expect the bulls of NEO to find a very strong area of resistance at $43. So if tomorrow I happen to see NEO bursting above this 180 SMA on the 4-hour chart and filling the gap up to $43, that is going to be the price target for me in order to close the swing trade that I just showed you. Or you since you never know, guys, when it comes to the stock market, if the bulls of NEO happen to be rejected at this moving average, they could potentially pay another visit down to $32. That's a scenario that I wouldn't roll out, guys. So if NEO happens to pay another visit to $32, there is going to be a spot in which I am going to be purchasing more NEO shares. $32 is a price, is an area that already acted as a support for NEO back on March 5th, but it also acted as a resistance for the bulls of NEO back on October 29th. So let's see how everything plays out for NEO in the upcoming days, guys. Let's see if NEO can fill the gap up to $43 or maybe pay another visit down to $32. And the last stock of this video, good old Tesla. Tesla went up today 4.40% and it closed today's trading session at $606.44. And Wells Fargo put out today a new price target for Tesla, $590. And Wells Fargo also said that Tesla is a hold. And remember, guys, when we talk about a price target, or whenever a bank or any financial institution puts out any price target for any given stock, we are talking about 12 months out, all right? So in the case of Wells Fargo, Tesla is already above the price that it should be 1 year out. So we can tell that pretty much some sectors of Wall Street are still absolutely clueless in regard to Tesla. And from a technical standpoint, guys, this is very, but very clear, at least for me. In the upcoming days, this could happen tomorrow, this could happen, I don't know, on Wednesday, Thursday, we are going to see two things. Either Tesla bursting above $620, which is going to be a very important area of resistance for the bulls of Tesla, and filling the gap up to the next very important area of resistance for the bulls of Tesla at around $660, which is also backed up, which is a price, which is an area that is also backed up by the 180 SMA and the 4-hour chart, or we are going to see Tesla paying another visit to the infamous $540. In my case, guys, if we happen to see Tesla paying another visit to $540, which is an area of support that already has acted as such in 1, 2, 3, and 4 opportunities before, I am going to be buying Tesla calls. Or If Tesla happens to burst above $620, remember that $620 is a very important previous area of support for the bulls of Tesla that already acted as such in 1, 2, 3, and 4 opportunities before. I think that Tesla is going to fill the gap up, as I said before, up to the 180 SMA on the 4-hour chart at around $660. $660 is an area that already acted as a support for Tesla in 1, 2, 2 opportunities before, but it also acted as a resistance for the bulls of Tesla back on December 8th. So let's see how everything plays out for Tesla in the upcoming days. Today, Tesla stock saw some sort of a nice recovery. And my hunch, my personal hunch, guys, is that $660 is coming sooner rather than later. So let's see how everything plays out for good old Tesla in the upcoming days. And with Tesla, I am going to wrap up the video. Thank you very much for your attention, and thank you very much for hanging out with me once again. Remember that here on the Bilingual Stock Market channel, we are posting these stock market update videos Mondays through Thursdays, right after the market closes. So if you want to have access to the notifications of our videos in a timely manner, you have to be subscribed to the channel if you haven't done it yet, and you also need to activate the notification bell right up there. Follow us on Instagram, guys, at Bilingual Stock Market. On our Instagram account, we are posting news and information on a daily basis, but most importantly, I am making call outs throughout the trading session about the stocks that I am about to buy. And remember that this is the Bilingual Stock Market channel, and also please hit that like button for me if you found value in this video. And remember that this is the Bilingual Stock Market channel, the YouTube channel in which we talk about the markets, but we do things a bit differently because we talk about the markets in English and Spanish. But most importantly, this is the YouTube channel in which we know that the wonderful world of Wall Street is not for geniuses, it is for entrepreneurs just like you guys and myself. My name is Alvaro, and I will see you guys tomorrow once again, right after the market closes. Peace out. Keep on crushing the markets, guys.